Hey guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.
103.3 WKFR FM and WKFR FM HD1.
A Town Square Media Station.
Dana and Jess in the morning.
Wake up.
Let's get started.
Good morning.
I listen every morning.
103.3 KFR.
Good morning.
Good morning.
It is Wednesday, November 29th of 2023.
That's right.
The weather today is going to be better than yesterday.
Thankfully. Gosh, this snow coming out of nowhere for me.
Yeah, it was a weird day.
Mm-hmm.
Cloudy and breezy today. Going to be above freezing. High of around 38. Coming up on the show this morning, going to drop some knowledge on you with hashtag Wednesday Wisdom.
Yes.
You know what's funny is, ironically, I've forgotten what the wisdom is. I have to look ahead. Oh yeah, the fastest speeding ticket in Michigan history.
Oh wow.
And it wasn't by a Michigander. That's the best part.
Even better.
It's the best part. So find out what that's all about with Wednesday Wisdom coming up later on the show. Also, Florida Woman Wednesday, kind of the opposite of wisdom.
Was it a Florida person that got pulled over?
No, it was not.
Oh, interesting. Okay.
You're close, though. All right, so Florida Woman Wednesday coming up, and we can't forget that 103 minutes of commercial-free music to kick off your workday.
Yes.
That's going to kick off just before 9 a.m. today.
Keep our workday moving.
All right, what do you say we start a show and stuff?
Yeah, let's get to it.
All right, here we go. All hands and feet in the vehicle.
Yes!
KFR. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's Dana and Jess, and this is a rough one. It's time to look down at Florida.
It's Florida Woman Wednesday. You can't make it up.
All right, Jess, what is it?
You weren't lying. This is a rough one. Florida cousins marry. Florida woman married her cousin. The blushing bride shared a TikTok video explaining that she and her cousin led a traditional lifestyle, with him being the sole provider and her a stay-at-home wife. They found out they were related after dating for 6 months.
That's okay. That's rough. Now, by the way, the reason why I chose this for Florida Woman Wednesday, because obviously there's also a Florida man involved. She's bragging about it on TikTok. That's why I'm alarmed, because imagine the bad luck that you are dating someone, you fall in love with someone, marry this person, only to months later find out that you're related. That is devastating. But bragging about it on TikTok, like, that's something you keep it on the low if that's the case. If you're like,
exactly,
I fell in love with you, so we're stuck here, which is, you know, not, why go on TikTok with that?
No.
Why?
I'm going to pretend it didn't happen and I didn't know that information.
And also, we need to know, now that you've let us in on the secret, when you say cousin, like, this could be so distant that it's not a big deal.
I hope so.
Because in some form or another, we're all related.
Right.
Right. So with that being said, are we talking about first cousins? Or are we talking about, like, fourth cousin three times removed? You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's a huge difference.
Yeah. We need to know details, a little more details on that.
If your husband is also your cousin brother, then we have issues.
I don't know that I could stay with
you. You guys have a kid and that kid becomes your, like, daughter niece. That's a problem.
There's a lot of red flags just going on up in here for me, so.
Florida, just because you touch Alabama.
Dana and Jess in the morning on 103.3 KFR.
103.3 KFR. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's Dana and Jess with your question of the day.
What's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title?
Let's start with you, Jess. What do you think?
Bye, buddy. I hope you find your dad.
Mine is These Toilets Are Ginormous, which is the same movie.
It's such a good movie.
Elf is fantastic in every way.
It is. It became one of my favorites.
Make work your favorite.
Yeah. Yes. Yes.
I love everything about that movie.
Me too.
All right, so what's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title? Tap the chat button on the KFR app with your answer.
Mark says, light the lamp, not the rat. Light the lamp, not the rat.
Do you know what that is?
No, I don't.
I had to Google it. I couldn't figure it out. It's a Muppet Christmas.
Oh, I would have never known that. I've only seen that maybe once.
Richland Nutrition said cotton-headed ninny muggins. Clearly another elf
we
reference.
Love it.
I wonder if that's going to be the favorite or at least most quotable for most of our listeners. We'll see.
Yeah.
What's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title? Tap the chat button on the KFR app with your answer. Reading some of those answers coming up in 103.3 KFR. Good morning.
Good morning.
It's Dana and Jess with your question of the day.
What's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title?
Tap the chat button on the KFR app with your answer.
Wendy says it's a major award.
What's that one from?
A Christmas Story.
Okay. So we're going to try to like guess all of these.
Yeah, this...
I did cheat and I Googled one at the last break, but I'm not going to do that again.
Well, I didn't know that one either.
I'm going to try to get them.
Okay.
And I'm already going to fail. Lori says, that's Bright Bumbles Bounce.
No.
I have no idea what that is.
Me either. I have no clue. Mm.
Well, somebody let us know.
Yeah. Shauna says, every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings.
I believe you meant to say, every time a bell rings, an angel gets its wings.
Yes, exactly.
I mean, that is a classic.
It is.
That is among the first Christmas movies that I can think of. Mm-hmm. And why all of a sudden the title of the movie just escaped my brain?
It's a Wonderful Life.
Thank you. There we go. Oh, wow. So Hannah says, Santa! I know him!
That was good. That was good. Well, our favorite.
Yeah, it's going to be Elf.
It is.
I love this game.
This is so
I don't even love Christmas movies except for like maybe
really?
Two or three. Yeah.
Oh, wow. I pretty much love them all, honestly.
How about the Hallmark Christmas movies? Be honest.
Can't do it.
Okay. My fiance nonstop watches these awful. Mm-hmm. I'm going to be in trouble. I don't care. These awful Hallmark Christmas movies. Basically, let me tell you what happens in all of them. Everybody get closer to the radio. Listen up. So a girl leaves her hometown and becomes rich and or famous, but her work life, man, it's busy.
Yeah.
There's no time for herself and she's very lonely. Mm-hmm. She finally comes home, probably because, you know, her grandma died. So she comes back home to her small town only to bump into the guy she had a crush on in high school.
Right.
Who now is this big, muscular, good looking guy.
Mm-hmm.
And he's not necessarily rich, but he's an independent, smart guy.
Yeah.
And no matter how hard they try not to fall in love, they do anyway.
It's happening.
So she gives up the career back in New York, and she moves back to the crappy little town where she's from. There. Now you don't ever have to watch a Hallmark
Christmas
movie.
You don't
Christmas
have to
movie.
Watch any marathon happening at all.
I did it!
That was really good. Dana, seriously.
Dana's a Scrooge.
No. It's the truth.
All right, so what's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title? Tap the chat button on the KFR app, and I promise I won't do that rant ever again. 103.3 KFR, good morning.
Good morning.
Dana and Jess here with your question of the day.
What's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title?
Tap that chat button on the KFR app with your answer.
Cindy says, you'll shoot your eye out.
Classic movie.
Yes.
That, by the way, it wasn't filmed there, but the movie took place in South Bend, Indiana, just like an hour from us.
Yeah, I always thought it was filmed there.
That's a good movie. Everything about it, from the bully, I'm friends of a friend of his.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, he's actually a pretty cool dude. He said people hate him when they meet him and they don't know why.
Yeah.
It's because they don't realize that this is the bully from A Christmas Story 30 something years ago.
Oh my gosh, right? Isn't that so crazy how that just like
he's
sits
a grown
in our
man
mind
now?
Right.
But you can just see it in his eyes or something.
Mm-hmm, that memory.
Right, this one is interesting. What's your favorite Christmas movie without saying the title? Chris says, Yippee-ki-yay, MF-er. It's not a Christmas movie! Die
Hard. Yes, that's right. I'm thinking,
This is the biggest argument in my relationship.
It is.
Susanna says that Die Hard is a Christmas movie. Mm-hmm. I say it's a movie. There just happens to be a Christmas, a work holiday party happening near it.
Yeah.
Or in it.
Yeah.
That's all.
So that's why it's on the Christmas list. Kendall says, why is the carpet all wet, Todd? I don't know, Margo. I don't know that one.
Why is the carpet all wet, Todd? I don't know, Margo.
Oh, wait, is that National Lampoon?
Yes, you did.
Okay.
I can't believe that's what did it. I can't believe it.
I don't know why either.
I love that scene when the icicle goes through the window and it's just, oh my, it's a mess. Chris says, it's a beaut, Clark.
We know that one too.
It's the same movie.
So good. So good.
I can't do the other quote from that character.
Oh,
The beeport is full. Yeah.
That's the classic.
I say I don't like Christmas movies, but I know all of these.
Yeah, that's what I mean. They're classics. They're good.
I'm
going
to get my Scrooge card taken away if I'm not careful.
Yeah, you're starting to have a little holiday magic in your eye there.
His heart grew three sizes.
I see that Christmas magic in your eyes.
I know them all. All right, we'll keep the answers coming in or just chat with us in real time anytime by tapping that chat button on the KFR app.
Dana and Jess in the morning
on 103.3 KFR.
It's Hollywood Dirt on 103.3 KFR. Here's Jess.
A moving truck was spotted outside Travis Kelce's new $6 million Kansas City mansion, and sources are saying Taylor Swift is allegedly preparing to move in during her two-month break from her tour. Furniture and other items were seen being carried onto the lavish property. It hasn't been confirmed that it was necessarily Taylor's furniture, but we'll see. Jamie Foxx is allegedly still struggling 7 months after a mysterious health scare. A source says Jamie pulling out of another project has friends worried that he hasn't recuperated as well as everyone thinks. He's struggling, but Jamie has been very private about what happened and his recovery. And we just wish him well here. Hopefully he will fully recover soon and be able to get back to being in the movies and we can see him again on the big screen. Beyonce's mother, Tina Knowles, defended her against accusations of skin bleaching. Tina wrote on Instagram, came across this today and decided to post it after seeing all of the stupid, ignorant, self-hating, racist statements about her lightening her skin and wearing platinum hair, wanting to be white. How sad is it that people continue the stupid narrative with hate and jealousy? Duh. She wore silver hair to match her silver dress as a fashion statement, clown. Don't come from Mama Knowles, apparently. And again, the ignorance is very real. So I think a lot of people really just need to stay out of the comments on all social media. And that's your Hollywood Dirt on 103.3 KFR.
103.3 KFR. Good morning.
Good morning.
Dana and Jess, time to allegedly make you smarter. It's Wednesday Wisdom.
Yes.
So you may have been wondering, I wonder what the fastest speeding ticket in Michigan's history was. Well, would you believe I have that answer? And it just happened a couple of years ago.
Really? Just a couple years ago?
So it happened in 2021. We were still in the depth of the pandemic. At the time, things were just different when it comes to enforcement of laws. So there were certain things where cops would not pull someone over unless they absolutely had to.
Right.
Because they didn't want to be a part of spreading COVID.
Sure.
And not as many cars on the street except for this 2016 Dodge Challenger Hellcat. This happened on I-75 in Monroe County. Very close to midnight. It was like 11:45 p.m. on a Sunday. And this dude was doing 180 miles per hour in a 70 mile per hour zone.
Wow. Where at? I-75, huh?
I-75 in Monroe County. So he was doing at least 110 miles per hour over the speed limit.
My gosh.
So there's not a lot of information we can get out of this because the guy's privacy is protected and, you know, blah, blah, blah. Here's what we do know. That he is from Ohio.
Oh, that's interesting.
So the man that has the fastest speeding ticket in Michigan's history is a Buckeye. Because of course it is. Have you ever driven in Ohio? Good luck.
Right.
So that's a thing. The other thing of interest is why?
Yeah.
And there was not a lot of information on that as well, because the police officer asked, you know, like, basically, is everything okay? Where are you headed? Because my thought is maybe this guy is rushing to a medical emergency. He found out a family member is not doing well. Something of that sort.
Right.
Here's what it says on the actual citation. Quote, my fault. I was speeding with another vehicle. Sorry.
Oh, my gosh.
That was the full explanation.
Okay. Thank you for that. What?
So if you've ever wondered what the fastest speeding ticket in the history of Michigan is, it's 180 miles. Well, actually, technically, it's 110 miles per hour over the speed limit.
Oh, my gosh.
And there's no word on how bad things got for him legally. Some people are saying he only had to pay a $180 fine, which is bonkers because if you're doing anything over 25 mile an hour over the speed limit, that is considered reckless driving in Michigan,
right,
which is jail time and a $500 fine. So,
yeah.
So kids, don't try that at home. Wow. Let that record stand.
Yeah.
All I'm saying.
Yeah. We don't need it to go any further than that.
Part of me feels a little bit satisfied that this awful record in Michigan is held by an Ohio resident. And that is your Wednesday Wisdom. Get the full story right now. WKFR.com.
The 103.3 KFR Facebook Friend of the Day.
Give us a like on Facebook, interact with us, and you could be our Facebook Friend of the Day like Frank Bradshaw. We have an article up on our Facebook page. Most Michiganders don't know this about the center turn lane. And Frank had this to say. Seems a lot of folks forget they're driving a car. Gosh, Frank, spot on. So true. Not even just because of Michiganders not knowing what to do in the center turn lane, but we also, some people have a hard time learning how to use that blinker when they're turning. And then don't even get me started about people driving in winter weather. It's just, yeah. Thank you, Frank, so much for interacting with us. And for that, you get this.
You get nothing. Good day, sir.
Yeah, sorry about that, Frank. But we appreciate you. Thank you so much for interacting with us. And again, if you want to be our Facebook Friend of the Day like Frank Bradshaw, just interact with us. Give us a like on Facebook, 103.3 KFR.
Dana and Jess in the morning on 103.3 KFR.
It's the birthday banger. On 103.3 KFR.
Tap that chat button on the KFR app. Send us your date of birth. We will find the number one song on your 16th birthday because that is your birthday banger. Let's get into it.
Contestant number one, Celine in Kalamazoo. Her 16th birthday was April 17th, 2006, making Celine's birthday banger Bad Day by Daniel Powder.
That's right, kids on TikTok. This was actually a number one hit before it just became a funny way for us to watch people have very bad days.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes. It's not a birthday banger.
It is not.
That is one thing it's not.
And when this song came out by Daniel Powder, all I could think of is that movie called Powder. So that's how what I pictured Daniel Powder to look like, he does a little
bit. Right. Yeah. He kind of does. Yeah. He is very pale and it's a whole thing.
All right, contestant number two is Kelly in Lawrence. Kelly turned 16 on October 28th of 1986, making Kelly's birthday banger True Colors by Cyndi Lauper.
See your true colors shining through.
Wow.
I love this song. Obviously, this is not a birthday banger.
Yeah, it's not.
Now, you notice how she sings this in like a childlike way?
Yeah.
I saw an interview where she talked about doing that on purpose because this song is for kids to understand. You know, it's like this big, I don't know. I was blown away that she had the forethought that when I sing this, I want a childlike delivery.
Okay, yeah.
Amazing. So now with that knowledge, if you listen to the song, it completely changes it.
Yeah, I think so. Absolutely.
All right, well, that's probably not a birthday banger though, but great
no.
song.
Contestant number three is Haley in Battle Creek. She turned 16 on February 17th, 2001, making Haley's birthday banger Miss Jackson by Outkast.
I mean, it's no flute solo, but...
Yeah, no, it's not.
I mean, come on.
And then that would not be a banger either, but
that
this...
whole double album set, the Outkast speaker box thing, that was just like, oh my God.
So good.
Yeah.
Outkast is classic, and that song's a classic, and it's a birthday banger.
I think so, too. I think putting Miss Jackson up against Bad Day and True Colors, Miss Jackson is the winner.
Yeah.
Bo show, so congratulations, yes. Haley. So we don't have any prizes for you.
No.
My apologies. Not today. But we are going to do your birthday.
Hey, guys, time to get in on the action for the biggest moments in basketball with Prize Picks, America's number one fantasy sports app. Just select two or more players, pick more or less on their projections, place your entry, and win up to 100 times your money. Right now, Prize Picks will match your first deposit of up to $100. Just download the Prize Picks app and use the code GET100. That's code GET100 on Prize Picks for a first deposit match of up to $100. Prize Picks, pick more, pick less. It's that easy.